So yes. I don't want to hold people up. As you all know, we're going to Ghana June 14th through the 28th of 2018. So for those of you who weren't at one of our initial meetings, I do have the itinerary here. So if you don't have an itinerary, please, you can get one now. And everything where we'll be going and what you're going to do. So pass them around. She's got them right there. So that is that piece. I don't want to go backwards in that because now that I have your email addresses, I will email you the link to our YouTube channel because we have a Ghana Travel YouTube channel and everything, every meeting that we have, I video it and then I put it up on YouTube. So you won't be without information, okay? Ghana has 10 regions. My husband and I just found out they're gonna split up a couple regions, so it might even be 12 by the time we get there. We're going to 5 of the 10 regions, all right? So we'll visit half the country while we're there. So we are really doing some heavy duty traveling. You need a passport, I put on the board. Do you have a passport?
Yes.
Now that's the one thing that we're not going to undertake for you. You must acquire your own passport. I have applications here and I'm willing to help people. That's a cost that you're gonna have to take on yourself. And that's the only cost that I'm asking you to take on for yourself. It's like $100 and some odd for a passport. But it lasts you for 10 years, so you'll be good for 10 years. That's an investment for you. All right? Now the cost.
This one here is very, very small.
Take one of these. The cost is very small, because I did a PowerPoint. The cost is about $3,400. I say between $3,400 and $3,600. That includes flight, transportation over there, lodging, 2 meals a day, all right? Visa costs and transportation on the ground while we're there, all right? That's what it is. Some of you have something different, all right? That's what it's going to cost. And listen how easily I say that. Because really, we're doing a lot for a little. It's not that much. Round trip, airfare. We're flying either straight into, we might make a stop at London.
Oh, that's nice. I've been in London.
Right. That's right. If we don't go to London, we'll go to Holland. All right. Holland is Dutch, the Dutch country.
Oh, same thing.
Yeah, same thing, going to Europe. Right. Now, I might not have enough of these.
Wait, Ms. Mintu, isn't
it
those flights
where we switch off? Yeah, it's round trip. Round trip airfare.
That means we don't
it's included in your cost. Excuse me?
That means we can't leave the airport. We have to stay in the airport.
Depending on how long we're there, usually we're not there too long. And remember, Beyonce's been here at almost every meeting. I asked the travel agent to not have us stay too long because I'm dealing with young people. And I know you like to explore, especially the SLA student. We're explorers and discoverers. But to do this kind of travel, I'm really responsible, highly responsible for you. And I don't want that much exploring on your own in a huge airport. Heathrow Airport is huge. London's airport, huge. And wait, and Tanisha, shopping up the yin-yang, girl. In the airport.
That's different money you got, you right?
Yes, it's the British euro. You would use.
I only have Canada money right now. I guess so.
Yeah, and you can get it everywhere you go in the airport. You can get the foreign money. Okay? So that's just one thing. So the cost is really, really inexpensive. You need immunizations. Yellow fever is the only shot you need. And write this down. You can get it at CVS Mini Clinics and Walgreens. Mini Clinics. CVS, Walgreens are so much cheaper than your travel clinics and your travel hospitals.
Say that we get a nail, but we have to still get it again.
10 years. It lasts for 10 years.
Can you get it at your doctors?
Yellow fever. The doctors usually don't give you the yellow fever shot.
Okay.
They'll send you somewhere to get it. All right? And it's your medical insurance and your parents' medical insurance usually don't cover it because it's for travel. Like my medical insurance didn't cover my yellow fever immunization. I had to pay for it. But you can call CVS's, the ones that had a mini clinic, call Walgreens and see who has the best price. All right, and you can do that at any time. All right, and I'm going through this stuff really quickly because the videos that I have online discuss all of that in detail. And then the visa cost, it's going to cost about $100 additional on to your price in order to have permission to visit Ghana. You have to have permission to visit. However, in the visa, I'm going to go back to talking about fundraising with visa because I already have a way to take away the visa cost by fundraising. All right? I'm already going to take that cost away from you. Now, the $50 deposit due the end of this month. Everybody has to make a final decision and pay a deposit to go on this trip so that we know who we're working with. I don't know if you know Dorian and Layla, and Beyonce has already left. They're truly the student leaders for this whole shebang. They're the student leaders because they have been in it since Mr. Johnson told me, Ms. Bantu, the children are going to Europe. I want them to go to Africa. You always go to Africa. Your husband is from Ghana. We want to go to Ghana. So that's how we're going. And my husband, Mr. Bentum, is going to go with us as well. And you'll see him on the videos, the other two videos, because it's his home. And he speaks the language. And he's going to be like a key for us. He'll unlock doors that none of us would be able to unlock because we're from a different country.
Do they speak French or like Creole?
Neither.
What do they speak?
They speak over 200 different tribal languages, but they all speak English. English is the language of educated people, so they do speak English. So you'll be able to talk to anybody and everybody when we go, all right? And we will be stopping at several schools. At all of the schools, they all speak English. And what we've decided, the only stop you don't see yet is an Islamic school, but because some students here are Muslim and they want to go, we're going to add an Islamic school onto the itinerary so that everybody's religion is represented while we go. Okay? Everybody is represented. So, the $50 deposit is due by September 27th. You have to have a money order, all right? Made out to SLA at Beaver. SLA at Beaver, you must have a money order. So this initial $50, how are you going to get it? Many of you worked this summer. Many of you got allowances. Have you put money to the side in order to at least have that $50? Everything else is going to come through fundraising. Everything else. So I wanted to talk about fundraising. Let me put up this cost so you can see it in a dollar amount. All right. So that's that. All right. It's anywhere in between that. anymore.
Okay.
No, that's a passport. If you don't need a passport, you don't need that. Here.
No problem.
She doesn't need that. Unless they ask for it. All right? Does anybody have any questions so far? I know I'm going fast. Because I'm going to ask Dorian and Layla to come and present real fast about fundraising. I'll end with the shoe sneaker drive, or you want me to start there? Because listen, the first thing that we're going to do that's going to cut out everybody's Visa cost is begin to collect gently worn shoes and sneakers. We're going to do that as our overall fundraiser and begin collecting so that we can raise between $3,000 and $5,000. That will wipe out every child's Visa fees, because it's going to be $100 per child, and those costs are on you, the individual traveler, like the passport is. But the Visa fee is a one-time fee. You can only go into Ghana one time on that. So I'm kind of feeling bad that that's a cost that you have to incur. Unlike a passport, once you buy your passport, it's good for 10 years. That's, you know, you need to be responsible for that. But for the Visa, since that's a part of the trip, I think we need to try to do something about that. So I said I'm willing to do a big sneaker drive, and in that way, everybody's Visa fees would be covered. How does that sound to you? Because guess what? We all have to be willing to do the work. I'm not doing all this fundraising work for you. You have to do it for yourself. You must do it for yourself. You know the kind of school where we go. We do things for ourselves. Once the information is put out there for us, we work it out. So we're going to have to work this out. But I'm putting my feet into it by getting us started by doing this sneaker and shoe drive. That means we have to connect to the community organizations, the teams that we're on, the churches, the synagogues, the mosques, the corner stores that we go to. Connect with the people that we know. Moms, aunties, grandmoms, grandpops, everybody that we know who has shoes, who has sneakers to give to us. Because we need to fill 100 bags of shoes, each bag holding 25 pairs of shoes, to earn $3,000. They'll pay us 40 cents a pound. And after talking with Miss Moran down the hall, and she does the old clothing drive, they pay her 21 cents a pound. So when she heard 40 cents a pound, she was like, wow. And I said, okay, then that's good, because she's been doing the clothing drive for a couple years. Okay? And if we can make that kind of money, that wipes out at least 25 children's, 30 children's Visa fees, just like that. You don't have to pay them. And the more you don't have to pay, the better. The more you don't have to pay, the better. But you're going to have to do the work. All right? So I'm starting there, and I'll let Dorian and Layla talk. We had a meeting the other day, and we discussed some things, so I'll let them share with you, and then I'll come back again.
So, in our meeting, we discussed some fundraising ideas. We discussed having a party, a talent show, and box tops on the cereal boxes, just with them all from random them.
General Mills. Mm-hmm. As a matter of, on this box stop thing, I'm sorry I have to interrupt. Because how about I went in the grocery store to buy cereal, and I thought about Dorian and talking about the box tops. And I'm like, cornflakes. Well, cornflakes doesn't do the box top savings. So I bought what the box top thing was, and they were all General Mills products. All right? And for every box top is 10 cents. For every box stop you have, it's 10 cents. Now you need to start looking in your households immediately, and you'll see how much of this stuff you have already in your house. And then you'll think about how much money you've already thrown away. Okay, because we can do a major collection. I'm going to talk to Dorian's mom about it, because Dorian, your mom did it with another one of your siblings, right? Something like that. I'm not going to interrupt anymore. I'm sorry.
Okay. So the so we was planning to have a party for like in the beginning of August, right?
October.
Yeah, October.
October 6th.
Beginning of October. And the idea was that you just paid your ticket like $8, but it included like a snack and a drink. So, you know, come party, drink and eat, and yeah.
And also, every other week or so, we'll have, we'll sell beef patties, and we kind of need help with selling those, because we don't have the same lunch all the time, and we'll need more people.
And that's the Jamaican beef patties. Remember that was being sold last year to those students. We sold a Jamaican beef patty and a juice, okay? So we'll continue with that as well. Question.
And we are allowed to conduct our own fundraisers too. Like
you're allowed to conduct your own fundraisers. Yes. Yes.
So like
that is going to be big. Now I'm going to develop a website for us, so GoFundMe for the entire group. Okay? I'm going to do that. But I didn't want to strike that until you all get in gear that you have work to do.
Yeah.
Okay, I don't want it, and Mr. Johnson does not want me, he really doesn't want me making it, but I don't see a way out of that. Mm-hmm. But you have to do the work to go. Mm-hmm. You have to, and you have to show your parents, you have to show your community, you have to show everybody. Listen, so when you go to sell yourself to get money from people to help you go, you're going to say, I want to go to Ghana, this is why I want to go. This is what I've already done, but I need your help too. Okay? So that's going to be our next meeting, how to sell yourself to get money to go. That's what I'm going to teach you how to do next. But I need you all to know you have to do fundraising, and I don't want to hold people up too long, but go ahead. I'm sorry.
Our meetings, we have on Friday and Tuesday.
I don't know when.
Yeah, Friday and Tuesday. And
Friday when?
Friday, it will only be like a 10-minute checkup, 30-minute checkup a week at most.
After school?
After school.
Okay.
And then Tuesday, it will go up to at least an hour.
No, I said 30 to 45 minutes, twice a month. Mm-hmm. All right, so that's what I said. Twice a month we'll meet so that we can do updates and check-ins. All right, because we want, if you showed up in this room, you want to go. And guess what? I want you to go too. Every single one of us needs to have this opportunity to travel. This is called studying abroad. And you're doing it at a high school level. And this is a big deal. And because you showed up, you took the first step, then I'm willing to have your back. So I want to make it so each and every one of you gets to go.
The other idea was a talent show. You know, come, express your talents, anything, poetry, singing, dancing, anything that you do, and come and just watch everybody.
We will hold. We have to make a proposal to Mr. Johnson, because he would like to know how can it be educational. So, and then we will have auditions. Where we'll come, see who they got, and then pass them to the next round. And also my mom, she was thinking of some ideas of how we can raise money, and she just went to the dollar store, bought a bunch of stuff, and just started decorating and creating these like little miniature stuff to sell to her friend and stuff like that. So
I'll say October 6th for this part. Someone said to me today, well, if we do the party, it would be the back-to-school party because nobody has one scheduled yet. It would be the first party of the school year for SLA. Now, being that it's in October and it's the beginning of October, we can set it off by doing a costume party.
Yeah,
okay. Okay? We can set it off by doing a costume party and then do a little contest, best costume, worst costume, whatever, and do a little prize or something. Okay? We can do that. And we can invite both campuses. Because guess what? We need their money too. We need their money. And so what the young people suggested to me was an $8 prepaid charge, which includes one snack, one juice. And then anything after that they have to purchase. And that at this particular party, people wouldn't be allowed to go in and out like we normally are. Allowed to go in and out, because people go out and down the street and around the corner and get the money to 7-Eleven. We don't want the money to go to 7-Eleven. We need their money to stay with us. So we have to have snacks available for sale after the one item that they get, a bag of something and a juice. And also, I want to say on the video, we're going to need the adult chaperones to help us with this, because I can't do the chaperoning of a party by myself. So we will need the adult help for supervision on that night. All right? So how is the costume party, Sam?
Good.
Okay? Yes.
Can we start I don't know how many people it is in here, but can we start like a committee where people actually dedicate like the planet, like, because we all can't plan at the same time.
So who has the sheet of paper? Take another page in the book and make it the party planning committee, one page, and talent show planning committee, other page. And then I need the shoe fundraising committee. Okay? The shoe one is going to be so easy. It's going to be easy. We just need to get the word out. And with this shoe fundraising, I'm working with another organization. How about they build a website, they send flyers, they give you a coach, a fundraising coach, and all of that. So I'm just looking forward to it. Because you know, as a teacher, it's hard. We don't have all the time to do all this extra stuff. We really don't, but I have to make time to do this with you and for you, okay? Now, as far as the $50 deposit by 9:27, if you think you're really gonna have a problem with that, let me know. Because you have to have a money order for $50 by the end of this month.
The money order is made out to SLA?
SLA at Bieber, yes.
Can I take a picture of that?
Yes. And if you wanted to give more than that for a deposit, you're welcome to do so. But the $50 is committed. Okay. The $50, you got everything you need now, Jay?
I got all the papers, yes.
All right. You didn't get a pack, did I give you? Okay. All right. What was that saying? If you want to pay more for a deposit, you can. You can. To defray some of your costs, to start the cost. You know, bringing it on down. Because by the end of the month, I want to pay $200. Because it's going to be me and Mr. Bentley. Now, we don't need visas. We don't need passports. We don't even need yellow fever because we have that. So, you know, we don't have to pay that part, but it's still a cost for us. Okay? Yes. $50 to you. Well, I'm the one, all the monies have to be turned in to me. Well, we need to have a check and balance of who everybody is going to go so that we have a definite list. Okay? So for this $50 deposit, start with me. All right? And then we'll make some other arrangements as we go along. Because Ms. Majerski has so much on her Cheyenne. Everybody just defaults to her. But she gave me my receipt book already. I'm already ready. Yes, she did.
We're still being in school, but we won't.
No,
we
won't. School ends June 12th.
I thought it was around 20th.
School ends June 12th.
Okay.
I have no idea about that, baby. I'm trying to stay with June 14th to the 28th and get us to Ghana. All right? I'm not sure.
Okay, so you said we were going to be visiting the 5 out of 10 regions, right?
Yes,
so
which are like states.
So how will we how will we go about doing that?
We'll have transportation while we're there, and we'll have a tour guide, and plus we'll have Mr. Bentoon. Mr. Bentoon is from Ghana.
Will we be staying in like homes or like hotels?
Oh no, we're staying in hotels, baby.
Hotels.
I cannot have, and the reason why you all can't stay in homes, because we come from the United States of America. Water issues are different. Mm-hmm. Bathroom issues are different. Mm-hmm. We need to stay somewhere where we know the water is going to be good enough to use on our bodies. Mm-hmm. Mr. Bentum and I already talked about, as soon as we get there, we're buying cases of water for you all. Mm-hmm. Because you cannot drink the water. Not because something is wrong with it, but our bodies
not used to it.
And so our bodies can't digest that water like they can because they've been here all their lives. Okay? So we're staying in our hotels.
Yes. We're on a plane right? So can we bring like snacks and stuff or no?
On a plane?
Yeah.
They let food on the plane, but you just can't, you know, do your over the abundance like you come to school with all that junk food. But they feed you on the plane.
For free?
But I'm saying,
on a flight like that, you'll get about two meals. It's 10 to 11 hour flight. So you get like a snack and a full meal, depending on where we, what time we travel.
What was the question?
Are we going to do a connected flight?
Oh.
So I'm still in betwixt and between. And really, it depends upon pricing.
I'm aware that we have to have like chaperone. Well, everyone doesn't have to have a chaperone, but there will be some chaperones. So how are we going to go about like rooming, like who's sharing rooms with who, or like
students, girls with girls, boys with boys. The adults have a choice of being by themselves, so that's why I have that range of prices. They can do the $3,600 to the $3,400, because it depends. So like Mr. Bentum and I, we're a married couple, we'll share the same room, we'll probably be at that $3,400 each in versus $3,600 because we'll be rooming together.
Okay, so it's two to a room, right?
Yes, I asked Mr. Lloyd, who is the travel agent from Palace Travel Agency, to do it like that because it's enough for us to have to deal with being in another country than having to deal with a whole lot of other people's stuff too. I figure if we stay with one person the entire trip, we can make that work to travel together.
To Paris, he was three.
So we don't bother one another, you know? And thus, that's why you have this packet that some of you don't have yet that talks about your personality and your character.
Mm-hmm.
So that we can match people up who are more similar in nature than opposite in nature. Or, Brennan, you might be on that committee to help, all right? To help me make decisions based on personalities, because my thinking might be wrong, okay? And then there's another group, my mentor, who when I became a teacher, she's a retired assistant principal now with the school district, Miss Connie Greer. She mentors girls here in the city of Philadelphia from junior high school. Some of them aren't in high schools. She's asked to join along with the trip. Her organization is called the Respect Alliance. The Respect Alliance. And they will be going too, but they'll be in their own rooms. They won't be in rooms with SLA students, but they will be joining us for the trip. They are going to help fundraise too. Ms. Greer could not get here today. I told her that we'll be on the web with this video and that I would need help right away with the party. Right away, and also with the shoes. Miguel, Nathan.
Can we bring like electronics and stuff, or we gotta leave them behind?
No, you can bring your electronics, honey. They have plugs, but you'll have to get a the transfer.
It was the SIM card.
The SIM card for the phone, because you can use your iPhone over there. But I'm talking about for the plugs.
It's an adapter.
Because their plugs aren't like our plugs. Theirs are like British plugs. And you can get those in Target, Bed Bath & Beyond, a lot of different places sell them. Rite Aid, CVS, Walgreens.
Ours have like three.
Theirs are different. I'll bring one in the next time. That was a good question, Miguel. That was a good question. I'll bring one in. Any other questions?
About the chaperone. So who chaperones?
We have a lot of parents who have been here. Like, they're not here today. I'm thanking her, but I really wanted this to be student-focused this time. Because the adults have been coming here. There were more adults the first time than there were children.
I didn't even remember.
There were more, I think, the second time, too, right? There have been more adults here than children because adults know the value of this kind of trip. They really do. So we've been talking about this since when, Layla? May was our first meeting last year. May. We started meeting in May. But no one has given us any money yet. That's why I have to make a deadline date. September 27th. Everybody has to send some sort of money.
Did you start making like the schedule for all the other deadlines for the money? Yeah.
No, I did not.
Okay.
Because I want to know who wants to go. Okay. I can keep doing this work and not know, and then all these people are always showing up, but no one has made a final decision. So that's why I need to know by the end of this month. So then all the hard work begins. All the deadlines will be set up. And if your parents want to contact me, you know they can email me at bbentumsla.org. I'm not going to say my cell phone number because this is going to be put up on YouTube. All right, I'm not saying my cell phone number. But if your parent wants my cell phone number and wants to talk to me, please tell them to email me. And I'll be more than happy to have a conversation with them on the telephone. Or even do a Google Hangout video. I'll do that too. Whatever. And really, because parents, you've got to let your children go to Africa so that we can begin to break down the lies.
Yep.
About what Africa is all about,
mm-hmm.
who lives there,
mm-hmm.
because it we have been fed a bunch of lies here in this country,
yeah.
about what the continent of Africa has to offer us.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So parents, please, please let your children attend. And they're in good hands. Mr. Johnson is even going with his son. So he is going as well. And I can't stress more how my husband is going. And the travel agent, Mr. Lloyd, is excited because he's been doing these types of trips since the 1990s. But this is the first time he's ever going over with a Ghanaian. So he's even excited. So, Dorian and Layla need help, and Beyonce, they need help, your help. I need your help. If we don't make this happen, it's not going to happen. Because you all know I'm a get stuff done kind of teacher. I am. But something like this, you have to put your initiative in it too. I can't do all of this for you. I can do all of this with you. So what you get out of it later will be for you. But this pre-work, I really need you. And we need to turn our campus upside down to let people know We are going to Ghana and we need your financial support. And people have money. And you all have money. As many Dunkin' Donuts cups I see coming in here, $5, $6 every morning people are spending on Dunkin' Donuts cups, juices, and beverages. I could afford it, but I don't buy it. But I don't buy it because I can't afford it. I cannot afford that. So if young people in this school can afford that Monday through Friday, people here have some money that they can give to us so that you can go to Ghana Africa. Holla if you heard. Okay? Any other questions? How many people do not have a packet, have never gotten this packet? Okay,
did
so
I get that last time?
How many people? Let's see how many
I
have.
Same for last time.
Yes.
Can you take one? Can you get one?
You have
one
too, Cheyenne. You do. You got it last year from your mother. Who else has it? Who else has it? Let's see.
Can you give me one, Nathan?
Now, let me make copies.
Unless Nathan came to the
I'm
house, right?
I'm going to
make copies.
Hi, Nathan. So, does everybody want to like chit-chat a little with each other while I make these copies? Because I have to go around. Stop, though.